Breaking right now, the FDA has authorized smaller doses of the monkeypox vaccine to try to increase the supply, which the White House says is running low. Here to answer your questions about that is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Thanks for being here, Doctor.
Great to see you, Dr. T. So let's begin with question one. The original plan for distributing the monkeypox vaccine was 2 full doses, roughly a month, 28 days apart. Now we're learning the FDA will reduce the amount in each shot to a fraction of a full dose. So in your professional opinion, will the smaller doses still prevent new infections?
Eddie, I really think this is a good plan. I think it's safe. I think it's going to be effective. And I think it's what the FDA has to do because the commissioner, Robert Califf, told us today that cases of monkeypox are increasing at such a rate that now the demand for the vaccine is greater than the supply. So we have to do something. What did the FDA do? Today, they just delivered an emergency use authorization for the monkeypox vaccine, we call it JYNNEOS, to be given in the intradermal route instead of the subcutaneous route. There's still going to be 2 doses, hopefully 1 month apart, but it's going to allow them to have 1/5 of the dose. So we're going to be able to expand the amount of vaccine fivefold. I just very quickly want to explain what an intradermal injection is. If this is the skin, as you can see, and I have the needle here, an intramuscular injection goes straight down into a muscle. A subcutaneous injection in the abdomen, for example, goes at a 45-degree angle, but an intradermal injection goes at about a 10-degree angle. Usually we use the forearm, and it just goes in so you see a little bit of a wheel. Okay, so it's and why does it work? Because in our dermis, it's rich with these cells that actually take up the vaccine and deliver it to where it needs to go. I do think this is going to work.
Perfect, Dr. Chi. Great example. Great.
You just answered his question.
Yeah, I was going to jump
before
in
before he even asked it. All right, interesting. So health officials in Massachusetts say that they have received several shipments of the vaccine from the CDC, but additional supplies won't get here until the fall. So how are you handling that delay at South Shore?
Right, Maria. Well, the Department of Public Health in Massachusetts just sent out a letter that basically said their strategy is going to be to now give as many first doses as possible and will delay the second doses until we receive further shipments. Now, there are certain people that have already scheduled their second dose. That will be honored. But really what we're going to do, and we talked about this with COVID way back when there were supply issues, is we're going to optimize and maximize the first dose, thinking that that is likely going to be able to prevent infection. And it's that second dose that may give more durable, immunity. But we really want to get right now, as we're seeing rapid increase in cases, we want to get more of those first doses out.
So given all of that, Dr. T, we've reached the point where you've told us getting a lot of questions from patients asking whether their rash, if they have a rash, could actually be monkeypox. So you sent us some pictures. So let's help clear up the confusion. To help explain, these are the photos you sent us. So what are we looking at? And why do you suspect monkeypox, or do you suspect monkeypox?
So we're going to start today with a monkeypox case, okay? So this is someone that has confirmed monkeypox, okay? He agreed that we could show these photos. So on the left, you can see that there's a pustule. This is on the finger, okay, on the back of the finger. And it basically, if you looked at that, you could actually, in someone, you might think, could this be hand, foot, mouth, if there were lesions elsewhere? But it's this second on the right-hand side. This rash is really unique for monkeypox. And I want you to look at the center of it, where you see that black crust, and then surrounding by about a quarter of redness that's a little bit heaped up. That is, it's the fact that you have pustules along with this type of crusted lesion with a heaped up border. That is what makes us think about monkeypox. Monkeypox can present as blisters, as pustules, which are sort of cloudy blisters. They can be crusts like this. Some of them can be painful. Some of them may be painless. You may see them on the genitals or in the mouth or in other parts of the body, but it's different stages of evolution. They don't all look the same. So that's an example of something that's confirmed monkeypox.
Dr. Tu, we have an after treatment picture too that we'd like to share with you as well. And is this what that area you just showed us would look like after the treatment, right?
So the Department of Public Health in Massachusetts was extremely helpful in getting this patient on TPOX, which is the antiviral therapy, within a couple of days from the diagnosis. Actually, the day he was diagnosed, we started therapy. And basically, you can see this is just 1 week after, and you can see how markedly improved it is. Mm-hmm. And some of these painful lesions are no longer painful. He's doing great. The other thing I want to mention quickly is that he recommended that two of his close contacts go and get the JYNNEOS vaccine, the monkeypox vaccine that we just talked about. Neither of them have to date, and one of them just got monkeypox. This is a problem. These can be painful lesions. You may have to be isolated for 2 to 4 weeks. We really want to do everything we can. If you're a close contact of someone with monkeypox, you want to go out and get this vaccine.
I just want to ask a really quick question. Is it itchy? Because for me, it can be itchy.
It can be itchy, it can be painful, it can be just neutral. So there's a lot of different presentations.
Because you think, okay, I have a bump. Did I get bit by something? Right. I don't know. Okay.
Right. Dr. T, thank you.
Thank you, doctor.
Very helpful. Thank you.